राधे कृष्ण, श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः, श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। वेलकम बैक टू द भक्ति सीक्रेट्स ऑफ द लेडी ऑफ तिरुकोळूर। आफ्टर अ ब्रीफ गैप इन द सीरीज ड्यू टू सम अनअवॉइडेबल रीजंस, वी आर नाउ बैक टू रिज्यूम द एपिसोड्स। सो इन दिस एपिसोड आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू गिव अ क्विक रीकैप ऑफ द सीरीज सो फार, so that it will provide a link into the upcoming episodes. So to start with the recap, we had seen Swami Ramanuja, who was one of the greatest devotees of Lord Vishnu, in one of his spiritual tours or pilgrimage. He visits a village called Tirukolur. As he is about to enter this village, he sees a lady who has packed up all her bags and is moving out of the village. Filled with curiosity, Swami Ramanuja approaches her and asks the reason for her exit from the divine land of Tirukolur, for which the lady replies with 81 statements. Wow, one question, 81 answers. Now, in these 81 answers or 81 statements, the lady is comparing herself with the devotion possessed by various people, various saints. And these incidents can be seen in Ramayana, Mahabharata, our Itihasas, Puranas, lives of great saints. She is benchmarking herself with the qualities which these people possessed. She's saying that she doesn't possess any of such great devotional qualities. So what difference does it make if she stays in Tirukolur or moves out of Tirukolur? The point here is, the lady, in spite of saying these things, she had the highest wisdom. Yet she had the humility to accept that she didn't know anything. Now, that's the greatest attribute which stands out. And even Swami Ramanuja, he never interfered when the lady was speaking 81 statements. Again, Swami Ramanuja, he knew every incident, everything which this lady was narrating. Yet he never interfered when she spoke. That also shows his humility. So all in, it is a series packed with devotional messages, lessons on humility, as well as lessons on positivity, positive speech, positive action, and positive mindset, which is very important to lead a happy and a peaceful life. And especially in these times of pandemic, positivity and the clarity in thoughts is an essential ingredient. So with this, let's recap the 13 bhakti secrets which we have seen so far. In the first bhakti secret, the lady of Tirukolur is comparing herself with the devotion possessed by Akrura. Now, Akrura was a minister in Kamsa's kingdom. Kamsa considered Krishna as his greatest enemy. When the time came for Kamsa to supposedly kill Krishna, he asks Akrura to go to Vrindavan and fetch Krishna to Mathura, where Kamsa thought he could engage in a fight with Krishna and kill him. That was his foolishness, but that's how the story goes. Now, Akrura, just because of his unflinching devotion to Krishna, in spite of being in a difficult situation under a difficult boss who would never give leaves, he still ensured that his devotion helped him to reach Krishna one day. So the lady starts her bhakti secrets by comparing herself with the devotion which Akrura possessed. In the next Bhakti secret, she moves to an incident from Mahabharata where she talks about Vithura. Now, Vithura is a person who has completely killed his ego, he has abandoned his pride, and yet he is leading a good life and fulfilling his duties. So we can also lead life without ego and pride. And this ensures that Lord Krishna comes rushing to his place for a humble lunch. Moving on to Bhakti Secret 3, the Lady of Tirukodur talks about the burning devotion which the wives of some rishis in Vrindavan had. And amongst that group, one lady gave up her life and merged into Lord Krishna when she was prevented by her husband from leaving the yajna in order to meet Lord Krishna. Then we go to Bhakti Secret 4, where it is an episode from Ramayana, and the Lady of Tirukodur is highlighting the steadfastness of Sita Mata in spite of being trapped by Ravana. After being kidnapped, she was trapped in Ashokavan in Lanka, and Ravana was trying to lure her. He was trying to tempt her with his financial might, strength, etc. But Sita Mata, just because of her focus in Lord Ram, she was able to avoid all these temptations, and she ensured that Lord Ram came to her rescue. In the Bhakti Secret 5, we saw that there was a king called Tondaiman Chakravarti who had great devotion towards Lord Balaji of Tirupati, and just because of this sheer devotion, he was able to wake up a dead man. Now, the message for us from that particular episode was to have that devotion even in difficult or impossible situations. Some solution may come out. Then moving on to Bhakti Secret 6, we saw that there was a ghost called Ghanta Karana who offered a corpse as a feast to Lord Krishna, and Lord Krishna, happy with such devotion, happy with such an offering, he gave liberation to that ghost. Then in Bhakti Secret 7, we saw Anasuya Devi, who was the wife of sage Atri, and how Anasuya Devi adorned Sita Mata just like a mother would do to her daughter in a limited time span which she got to spend with Sita Mata. In Bhakti Secret 8, we saw the story of Dhruva, who was a 5-year-old kid, and he was rejected by his father from playing on his lap. Yet this rejection didn't deject him, and that prompted him, that motivated him to go and seek Lord Narayana as the ultimate father. And at the age of 5, through intense meditation and tapas, he was able to have a vision of Lord Narayana. He was inspired by his mother and sage Narada, who gave him the technique of meeting Lord Narayana. Then in Bhakti Secret 9, we saw the story of a prince turned criminal called Kshatrabandhu. So what did this Kshatrabandhu do? Was to go into the forest and kill all the people and engage in criminal activities, till he came contact with a sage who inspired him to chant the name Govinda. Now, Shatrubandhu was not convinced because of his criminal past, yet somehow he started chanting the name Govinda continuously, and that ensured that he turned from a criminal to a devotee, which ensured his liberation as well. Bhakti Secret 10 was about Ahalya Devi's devotion to Lord Ram. In spite of being criticized for her actions and cursed to be turned into a rock, Ahalya Devi could still do that devotion towards Lord Ram, and she was liberated by a speck of dust from Lord Ram's feet, which gives us a message that when we are faced with situations where the external world is criticizing us, there are blemishes, instead of focusing on these external factors and getting our mind cluttered, it is better to look inward, have faith and find solutions. In Bhakti Secret 11, the Lady of Tirukkolo talks about Andal, who was the only female saint amongst the Alvar saints. And the speciality about Andal was she attained spiritual maturity. She ripened at the age of 5. So the message for us from that episode, which we discussed then, was people at various stages of life attain material prosperity. They may even end their life without having any inclination towards spiritual prosperity. Yet, here there was a girl, 5 years old, who matured spiritually at such a young age. So it was a message for us as well, that in spite of having material prosperity, progressing in our lives, we should have some inclination, some proclivity to the spiritual part as well. Then in the Bhakti Secret 12, we saw about another great Alvar, Piri Alvar, who was the father of Andal. And he was a very simple man engaged in devotional activities. When at a point in time, he had to debate with the scholars on various Vedic interpretations, on the Itihasa and the Purana, of which he didn't have a great knowledge about. Yet, because of his unconditional faith in Lord Vishnu, he could go and face those scholars with success. And once he won the debate, the king showered his praises. He basked him in the glory. Yet, Piri Alvar had that maturity to be humble even in those moments. So, these were the aspects which were highlighted by the Lady of Tirukkolo. In Bhakti Secret 13, the Lady of Tirukkolur talks about another Alvar called Tirumarisai Alvar. Now this Alvar had a quest on what is the cause of the universe, what is the cause of the creation. And with this quest, he researched on various topics. He poured into the Vedas, into the Puranas, various other scriptures. He meditated on various forms. He in fact converted into different religions as well to see if he could get an answer to this question. After multiple attempts, he was able to realize that it was Lord Vishnu who was the cause of the creation and this universe. That gave him the ultimate satisfaction. So his message was very clear, that in spite of many distractions, or commonly the information overload, he stresses on grasping the summary and leaving out the unnecessary details, which leads to a clutter. So these were the various messages which Lady of Tirukodur communicated through her 13 Bhakti secrets. So from the next episode, we will be continuing our regular weekly episodes, where we will be discussing about the life histories and various other great personalities as described by the Lady of Tirukodur. Radhe Krishna, Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, Srimate Ramanujaya Namaha.